Blitzmakers, welcome back to my videos. I am Jules Blitz, and today I'm going over one of my all-time favorite tank destroyers, this being the Scorpion G. Now, if you're not aware what this tank is and saw it come in the store today and be like, wow, this thing's new, this is a Tier 8 German tank destroyer. It is one of the best German tank destroyers in the game, in my opinion, and it is my favorite tank destroyer, I'd have to say, out of every tank in the game, because it has this excellent gun, it has excellent mobility, it has everything you'd want, all packed into this little, awesome tank. Well, actually, when I say little, it's not a very small tank. But other than it being a quite big target and a HE magnet, it is an excellent tank at doing the job. Now, I'm going to go over the statistics as I always do, and then I'm going to show you guys one of the most amazing replays I've played in the tank in a couple months. I managed to play it about 10 minutes ago, just trying to get replays for this video, so I hope you do enjoy. Starting off, this tank has 1150 hit points, which is actually a pretty decent amount for tank destroyers. Most are sitting at around, I'd say, 1,000. So this does have quite a bit more hit points than you would expect for a tank destroyer at tier 8, so that is a big, nice bonus. So what I would suggest to do, well, it's not a suggestion, I would say to do, is put on the hit point buff. If you don't, you are insane, because this thing has about zero armor. But yeah, you put the hit point buff on, you actually are able to withstand 3 AP shells or whatever that do 400 damage. Before that, you aren't statistically, so that is pretty nice to know. You can see we've already picked up some damage there, that nice little snap on that low. And you can see that this gun is just amazing. This tank has 277.2 meters of view range, which is very good. That's medium tank view range, and mixed with this excellent camo rating it gets, even though it's such a large target, you're actually able to outspot most mediums and heavies in the game. Well, heavies are easy to outspot, but you can actually outspot some mediums trying to push on you, which is nice to know. Now, this tank has 2849 damage per minute with 246 millimeters of penetration, which is very, very nice. And if you can't penetrate with your standard rounds, just load in that APCR, 311 penetration, but your average damage goes from 460 to 390, which means you're pretty much an IS-5 or something like that, just with ridiculous penetration. Not to mention, because this tank is such a high damage per minute, it only has a 9.7 second reload, which is ridiculous, because if you recall, the IS-5 has about an 11 second reload, which means that if an IS-5 were to shoot you for 400, you could shoot him once, shoot him twice, back up behind cover before he can get the shell in, because you're going to shoot each other the first time at the same time, which means you're going to deal, what is that, 920 damage to him, and he's going to deal 400 to you, and if he's smart enough, he'll shoot an HE. And that's a pretty good trade. You can see there, I traded shells with that AMX. I was able to out-reload him pretty much. That's how amazing this gun is, picking up 3,700 damage. And that was just a nice little simple game in this tank. Now, one of the issues with this tank that I do have is the shell velocity is only 920, and with the slow turret traverse speed, that can be a bit of a pain sometimes, but really, it's not the end of the world. Not to mention the base aiming time is only 1.72 seconds, and the dispersion is 0.29. The aiming time on this tank just never, ever gets large. If you didn't know, this has the same gun pretty much as the Waffle Tractor's 460 Alpha at Tier 9. This tank actually has the same damage per minute, just less penetration, and that is the only downfall. Every other statistic with this gun is actually better than the Waffle Tractor, a Tier 9 tank destroyer, which is insane. This tank also has 6 degrees of gun depression, 14 degrees of gun elevation. It has a fully traversable turret, but it does turn quite slow at only 21.87 degrees a second. Now, this tank also weighs quite a bit, so you can ram RHMs and stuff like that, and because your high explosive does a crazy 600 damage, you're actually able to take off, I bet, 1,000 of their hit points if you were to ram them and shoot them at the same time. Not to mention, this tank is also very quick, going 55 forwards and 20 backwards. Now, unfortunately, the power-to-weight ratio is only 15.14, which means that it's not amazing. However, it still is good enough to at least chase down targets. Your average speed, I say, is about 30, 35. Now, the traverse speed is also pretty good at 36.45. That's excellent for a tank destroyer. Mix that with your 22 degrees a second turret, so you're turning at about 50 degrees a second, so you're able to snap pretty much any tank that tries to flank you. And the next game, you're going to see just how excellent it is. And the concealment is 24%, which is pretty much the same as, I'd say, like a T-44. So it's got very nice concealment. But let's get stuck into that just amazing second replay. Now, we are on Fort Despair, and Fort Despair is actually not an easy map for a tank destroyer, especially one that has very light armor and a very big profile. And this tank checks off all the boxes for that category. And it doesn't do a crazy amount of damage, which means that people aren't as afraid to trade shells with this tank as they are with an RHM. However, that is not going to stop me from being super aggressive. Now, I'm gonna let you guys know now, if you are a player that doesn't like to camp, if you're an aggressive player, and you really just don't have the patience to camp, this is not the tank for you. This tank, you have to pretty much be very patient. Unfortunately, I am not patient. However, that's why I really sucked in the tank when I first got it. And I kept wondering, I spent so much money trying to get it in these crates over and over. I kept playing this thing. I probably played 100 games in it until I finally realized how to run it. And you really have to run it really carefully. You always have to pay attention to the minimap. You have to know where everything's happening. You have to know when to push, when to hide. You can see I knew that the enemy team wasn't going there, to the side I'm at, but I don't want to push past this bush because there are sometimes tank destroyers that like to sit there. So I'm trying to be careful. Now you can see we just missed that shell. It just goes above him, unfortunately. But that aiming circle is just so great how quick it can aim in. And wait until you see this shot here. We got this T-44, and I've got my teammate who's about to just stick his gun barrel right in my face, but that's not going to stop us. Boom, right through the top of the turret. It was a low roll, but I was grateful it even penetrated in the first place. Welcome to the RHM family, because for some reason these guns are ridiculous and just penetrate every single shell that shouldn't penetrate. Except for the shells that when they really should penetrate, they like to ricochet off. However, this gun is probably my highest accuracy gun, one of them at least, at tier 8. It's probably, I'd say, 94% hit ratio because it's such an excellent gun. It's really 5 times better than the WT gun, in my opinion. It's just such a good gun. And it's on a mobile chassis, which means that you can run this tank around the map. You can push on players really easily. You can see here the Kampfpanzer. I'm gonna just snap him in the back right there, light him on fire, 500, 600 damage dealt to him. We didn't even get spotted because that's how sneaky this tank is. Now we've got the E-75, get a shell into him. It was a super, super low roll, but I watched him just shoot right there, which means that I can get another shell into him. Now, unfortunately, he's just angled his tank enough that it will not penetrate. I was gonna load the APCR, but I'm like, nah, I can penetrate. Well, I jinxed myself on that one. However, WT, boom, 647. We make up that low roll by getting a high roll on him. He is now a one shot, and we've already managed to pick up 2,000 damage. And right now, it's a 1 versus 4. But we get a nice little snap right into the corner of that VK. I thought that 49 was trying to be a little sneaky deaky and pull around this corner. However, I think he realized that was not the best idea. He backed up here. Come on, are we going to be able to get him? Come on. And it just misses. Now, I'm not sure why he didn't pull out. He probably realized that if he pulled out and shot me, he would die, and he needs to go clear that E-75 because he's actually doing a pretty good job. But right now, you can see this is a 1 versus 3. And I am up against a VK-100P, which can shoot me with high explosive for a 600 average, and the T-49, which can shoot me with high explosive for 700 average, and an E-75, which I don't think he's running the good gun, which is really good for us, but it's still a very healthy E-75. Now, what I was expecting at this moment was for the 49 to be flanking around me. And you'll see what I mean by that in a second after I shoot this E-75. Come on, yes. Now, I expected the 49 to come up behind me here at the rear of my tank because that would be the most logical spot for the 49 to push. So, I am positioning my tank towards where I think the 49 will pull around. However, he really screws up his push and he gets spotted. And I really don't want to shoot this E-75 right now. And he's smart by not pulling around that corner. But this 49 just tries to get the jump on me, and we manage to get the jump on him, spotting him right around that corner. He's dead. The C-75 doesn't realize how quick our reload is. Come on, load that APCR. I'm not taking the chance of it bouncing. Ah, the fire doesn't get to him. He does have a repair kit. But as I said, this tank has an insane reload, and since he doesn't have the good gun, it doesn't matter. He only took 600 off us. We just managed to back up in time, and now it's me versus the VK. Now, that VK, if he's a smart player, can potentially one-shot us very easily just with any high explosive to contact me. So I need to be very careful. So I know that my view range and camera rating is excellent, so I'm going to go over to this bush here and try to spot him, and he's not going to know where we are. And yes, he doesn't. Are we going to get the shell on? Yes, we do. He just misses the shot. You can see it hit the building or the wall right next to me. He's got 79 health. However, I still can't afford to get hit by him because he still technically has the advantage on me, as his high explosive will do average damage and kill me easy one shot, where I actually have to penetrate my shell and get up close and personal. He just peeked out there. He missed his shell somehow. Don't ask me how he missed it, but he did. 3 damage. That is not good. But remember how I said this tank has an excellent reload? Well, guess what? It does. Boom. Dead. That is a Kalabanos you just saw there. 4,300 damage. Pissed off every player on their team, which is even greater. It was just an excellent game. You can see 52,000 credits. With premium on, we probably would have earned about 90,000. Just a mastery. We managed to pick up every award you'd wanted to get. And only 2 of the shells missed. Every single one that did hit did penetrate, which means that that's really good to know. It's just, to be honest, this is my favorite tank destroyer. And for $50, so $50, I kind of think it's worth it, but you have to be willing to learn how to play it. If you don't like being patient, this tank is not for you, because you have to think outside the box when you run this vehicle. You can't push it aggressive. It doesn't do well pushing up against heavies, because even if you hit them for 460, they're going to hit you back, and you have less hit points than them to begin with, which means you're still on the bottom end of the barrel. So really, don't push this tank aggressive. It is a camping tank, and if your team yells at you for camping in it, they're wrong. And if any of you have yelled at players for camping in this tank, please don't. The main purpose of this tank is to camp. It has an excellent gun for far distance. It's like a grill. That is the main purpose of this tank. However, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I'm going to leave my Discord in the description below. As always, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.